Programs, Outreach, and Youth Services Manager here at Monterey County Free Libraries. Thank you for joining me today for another Make It Monday. Today, we are going to make bugs. Bzzz. For this project, you're just going to need a couple of things. You are going to need a toilet paper roll tube or a paper towel roll tube cut in half. Or if you want to make a really long bug, you don't need to cut in half. You are also going to need some yarn. You can use as many colors of yarn as you like or just one color, it's up to you. For mine, I use 3 different colors of yarn. You are going to need 2 pipe cleaners. You are also going to need some paper, any color that you like. And then you are going to need scissors, a pencil, tape, and if you have one, a hole punch. If you don't have a hole punch, you can ask an adult to help you make holes using your scissors or by punching a hole with a pen or a pencil. You're also going to need something to create eyes. So if you have googly eyes, you can get those, or if you have eye stickers like I do, you can use those, or you can draw your own eyes. Plenty of different options. So gather up your materials and I'll meet you back here to get started making our bugs. To get started with our bugs, we are going to take our toilet paper roll and our hole punch, and you are going to punch 4 holes. So you're gonna punch 1 in, you're gonna scoot the hole punch as far as it'll go and punch. And then you're going to go to the other side, so try to make them directly across from each other. Punch there. And then you'll do the same thing for the other end of the toilet paper too. They don't have to be perfectly aligned. So in the end, you will have 4 holes. Now, if you don't have a hole punch, that's okay. You can ask an adult to help you make a hole with scissors or with a pen or a pencil. The important thing is to just have the holes so that they are on opposite sides of the tube. Next, you're gonna take one of your pipe cleaners and you're gonna put it into one hole and then have it come out the other side. And you might have to look in to see where your holes are. As you can see, mine aren't completely on the other side, but close enough. So you're gonna put it like that so that they're even on either end. And to secure the pipe cleaner, you are going to wrap it around the top and have it come back out through the same hole. So it forms a loop like that, which will secure it in place. So you'll do that to both sides, which is why it's important to make sure that it's even on both sides. Otherwise, you'll get an example like this, where the legs aren't gonna be the same size. I clearly need to readjust my pipe cleaner length. And once you have one set of legs, you're gonna go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. And those are our legs for our bug. Next, what you are going to do is you are going to take your scissors and you are going to make a small slit at one end of your toilet paper roll. So just a little slit like that. That's where you're going to thread on the yarn to get started wrapping. So you can take whichever color of yarn you would like to use first, or if you're only going to use one color, then you just take that color. And what I like to do is keep it attached to the bigger roll of yarn itself, because I'm not sure how much I'm gonna wanna use. And after this, you are just going to start wrapping it up. It's good to unravel a chunk. If you wanna use multiple colors, you'll just do a few wraps, however many wraps you wanna do. You can make your bug as wrapped or as unwrapped as you want. If you don't want any brown of the cardboard tube showing, you can wrap the whole thing. If you want some brown to be showing, you'll wrap a little bit less. Once you've done one color, you'll just put the next color through the same slit. You can make a slit on the other end if you want to start wrapping from the other end, and you'll just continue wrapping till you have as much wrapped as you like. Adjust the legs however you like. Also, what I forgot to mention before we got wrapping, it was to secure the ends of your yarn when you're done. You can either wrap it back so it goes into the slit at the top if you want to do that, or all you need to do is tuck it under some of the layers of yarn to secure that little last bit. And it should be pretty secure between the slit and the tucking. Now we are going to make our wings. So we'll put our bug body aside for a second, and we are going to take out our paper, whatever color paper you want to use for your wings. You can make your wings look however you want for them to look. They can look like butterfly wings, they could be circles, half circles, triangles, squares, whatever you want to do, whatever shapes you want to make. For mine, I am going to do half circles. So I am going to draw one big circle, and then when I cut it out, I'm going to cut it in half, and those are going to be my two wings. Here are my wings. I'm going to put my paper aside. I'm going to bring out our bug body, and you just need to decide where you want your wings to go, which part you want to be your head and which part you want to be your back legs. So I'm going to have my pink pipe cleaners be my front legs. I'm going to have my wings go like this. Now, if you have a hot glue gun, this is a great place to ask an adult to help you use it. You would just put a dot of hot glue there, put one of your wings on, another hot dot on top of that, other wing on, and you're good to go. I don't have a hot glue gun, and I don't have any white Elmer's glue, so I'm gonna get my tape back out, and I am going to fold it over to make a little tape loop like this. I'm gonna place the tape loop where I want my wing to go at a slight diagonal so that it covers as much surface of the wing as possible. And I'll put one wing on top there. And then I'll do the same thing with another tape roll and put that on top. Add a bit of a diagonal and put my other wing on like that. And now I have my wings. Next, we are going to do our eyes. So if you want to create your own eyes, you can bring your paper back out or a different color piece of paper and draw eyes. You're going to cut those out and glue them here. If you have googly eyes, you can glue them to the top, or I have my trusty eye stickers. So I am going to add on some eyes with my eye stickers. I love eye stickers. You can find them online or at craft stores. I think they're fun because there are a lot of different expressions that you can get. Pzzz, there's my bug. And if you want to add some character to your legs, you can bend the legs so that it stands up. You can have them sticking out straight, however you want to have them. I'm going to have mine at a slight angle, front legs facing forward, back legs facing back. And my bug is ready to fly away. Bzzz. I hope that you had a great time creating these bugs with me today. If you did this craft and you want to send me a picture, please leave it in the comments below. We love to see completed crafts, or you can tag us on Instagram at @e_mcfl. And if you want to learn more about bugs, you can check out some bug books from our catalog by visiting our website, www.emcfl.org, or by visiting your local MCFL branch and talking to one of the library staff there. I will also be doing a rhymes and songs session on Wednesday at 11:30, all about bugs. That video will be posted on our YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram social media channels. That you have a fun time with your bugs. I'm gonna fly off for now, but I will see you next time. Bye!